Good morning, students, and today's session is we are going to discuss about knowledge management. First, we'll start with the intro of knowledge management. What is meant by knowledge management? So, if you are going to take an organization, how the knowledge is going to be shared among the employees with the eligible and available resources? That's what we are going to call as knowledge management. For example, if we take our college, so whatever resources are available here, number one, we have professors to share their knowledge. Number two, we have library where you can lend the books through which you can get some knowledge, or you may use a digital library through which you can avail the online knowledge from IEEE journals. So these are all the resources through which you are going to gain some knowledge, and this knowledge is going to be shared among yourselves. For example, professor like me is going to share my knowledge with you, and you are going to share your knowledge with your friends too. Got it? So this knowledge can be divided into two different categories. First one is we call as implicit knowledge. Now number two is tactic knowledge. So what is meant by implicit knowledge? So just now I gave a live example. Implicit in the sense, the knowledge sharing is going to take place within a particular organization. Okay, so just now I gave an example. We are going to use library and professors are going to share their knowledge with you. This is what is called as implicit knowledge. And whereas the second one is very, very important, that is tactic knowledge. So what is meant by tactic knowledge? So the knowledge sharing that is going to happen from outside the organization. For example, here we are going to have some seminars, we are arranging for guest lectures, we are arranging for initial visits. So what is the need for them? What is the use of it? So the external persons, for example, a professor from an university or from an industrial person who is an HR or who is a tech lead, will come and share his experience or his knowledge with you. Got it? So the knowledge which we are going to share with you comes under implicit, but whereas the knowledge which is going to be shared by the external person is called as tactic knowledge. Clear? Got it. Next, we'll move on with knowledge management process. It is a pyramid structure. The base will be data, which is a basic one, followed by information. The last one is gaining of knowledge. Okay, so whenever we are going to start with the knowledge management process, first we are going to start with data. So what is meant by data? Data is a raw material for an information which is meaningless. So what we are going to do by using this data, we are going to first collect the data. So the first step here is collection. We are going to collect the data. So for collection of this data, we are going to have a team. This particular team will work and they are going to collect the data. So after collecting this data, we are going to organize the data. So for this, we are going to have a team number two. So this particular team is going to organize the data. This is the first step in your knowledge management process. Got it? Next, after collection and organizing of this data, we are going to move on with the second important part, which is called as information. So what we call as information? So the raw materials which we have collected by using this data team is going to be converted into an meaningful information. So the steps which we are going to follow in information is, number one, we are going to synthesize this datas which you have collected. Synthesizing in the sense, the datas are going to be converted into an meaningful information. Got it? So step number one is collection of data. Step number two is the datas which you have collected are going to be organized. And step number three is synthesizing where this particular data collected will be converted into an useful information. The last one, very, very important one, is decision making. So this is what we call as knowledge. So the data which have been synthesized, that means which has been converted from data into information, is going to be directed to an head team, which where they are going to take some decisions using the information that is given from the base. Okay, so the session, today's session, we discussed regarding what is meant by implicit knowledge, the knowledge sharing that takes place within an organization, and tactic knowledge, the knowledge that is going to be shared by the external persons or external entities, that we call as tactic knowledge, and a pyramid structure, which is called as knowledge management process. The base is the data, which is a raw material for the information, and we are going to have a special team for collecting. Next, we move on with information, where we have a step called as synthesizing. This particular step is going to convert the data into information. At the last, we are going to have a decision-making process, where your information is going to convert it into knowledge.